So, you've created a cool new genetically engineered organism. Maybe it's a dog that can meow, or a cat that can help you with your taxes. Either way, you're probably thinking it's about time to unleash it on the world and collect your Nobel Prize, right? Well, hold on a second. First, you need to convince the world that your technology is safe to use. Let's take a look at an example from real life. A case where scientists realized the risks of their own work and took action, and why that was crucial in their success. This is the story of the discovery of recombinant DNA and the lessons that we can learn from it. First of all, what is recombinant DNA? Recombinant DNA is essentially DNA that has been edited in a laboratory to bring together genes from different sources. Today, this is a common technique in labs, but this was groundbreaking when the technique was first discovered by biochemist Paul Berg in 1972. This was the first time this was possible, and science had no idea what the consequences could be. In fact, Berg never actually completed the final step in his project of inserting the new viral DNA into bacteria due to concerns that it might escape and cause cancer in the lab workers. Berg paused his work, and 2 years later, in 1974, he and other scientists working on recombinant DNA formed a coalition, the Committee on Recombinant DNA Molecules, and issued a letter to the scientific community, calling for a moratorium on certain experiments using this recombinant DNA until the risks could be further assessed. The coalition asked for a pause specifically on experiments where the recombinant DNA could potentially enhance antibiotic resistance of bacteria, increase levels of toxin production or introduce new toxins to bacteria, or cause cancer in humans. This moratorium was upheld by scientists worldwide, until a formal conference was held the next year to discuss the risks in detail and set guidelines for scientists to follow for the foreseeable future. The Asilomar Conference of 1975 was organized by the coalition to discuss and regulate the ethics of their own work. The conference was attended by about 140 professionals, not just scientists, but lawyers, doctors, and journalists too, all contributing and adding to the discussion. Eventually, they settled on categorizing each kind of experiment into one of three risk levels, each with different containment procedures. These containments proved effective, even forming the basis of the official US government regulations in 1976. To date, these regulations are observed, and to date, none of the fears expressed by Berg have been realized. But perhaps the most effective part of the conference was that it earned the trust of regular people. People who don't care which restriction enzyme was used to digest the viral genome, but do care about potential cancer-causing antibiotic-resistant superbacteria. For the general public, seeing media coverage of scientists heavily debating the possible risks of this technology and regulating their own work was comforting. While we eventually figured out that recombinant DNA wasn't as scary as it seemed at the time, there are always new, potentially terrifying biotechnologies on the horizon. For example, CRISPR. CRISPR is a system that bacteria use to fight viral invaders by destroying their DNA. Recently, scientists have figured out how we can hijack that system to make incredibly targeted modifications to DNA sequences, even in humans. Similarly to Berg's discovery of recombinant DNA, this has the potential to revolutionize genetics. But much is still unknown about its potential. There are concerns that CRISPR might not be specific enough, that other unrelated genes might be caught in the crossfire. Additionally, genes are rarely simple, and a slight change to the expression of one gene could have many unintended effects on the expression or function of others. Again, this sounds similar to Berg's discovery. In fact, scientists have already enforced a temporary ban on the editing of human embryos using this system, until its safety can be determined, which raises an interesting question. How can the safety of editing human embryos be assessed if not by editing human embryos? Even if the safety of CRISPR is assured, there are still ethical issues to be addressed. How can this level of genome editing in humans be brought to the world stage without stretching the fabric of society? These kinds of questions can't be answered by scientists alone, but it is up to the scientists to lead and frame the discussion for others to participate in, and so the public can watch. Ultimately, Scientists need to lead the way in managing the potential risks of their own work to gain the trust of those who their discoveries will affect most. With exciting and scary new discoveries happening every day, it's important not to forget what we've already learned. Paul Berg won the Nobel Prize for his work on recombinant DNA, but there's much more to the story than just the science.